Hi, everyone. So welcome to another session. I'm here with Ruslan from Jelastic. Let me just check. Is everyone in the session yet?
Hello,
Can you
everyone.
Hear us? Okay, so let's just give it a minute. Oh, I can see Andre is here. So we're definitely live, and I'm super excited to say hello to Ruslan from Jelastic. Jelastic is providing amazing support for Jakarta EE, and not just Jakarta EE working group. So they're heavily involved with the micro profile working group as well, with the Clips Foundation. And we certainly appreciate having the platform as a service from Jelastic supporting Jakarta EE. Ruslan, you are supporting us not just with the technology, but there is another support that I almost fainted what I saw. So do you want to introduce yourself and show off that fabulous creation that you have for us today?
Hello, Tanya. Thank you very much for warm words and for this nice introduction. I'm glad to be here with you and share this nice day, celebration of new release of Jakarta EE 9. So my name is Ruslan. I'm co-founder and CEO of Jelastic, which is platform as a service for developers. And we do support Jakarta EE. We love Java, and we put a lot of efforts to, you know, to provide a smooth experience for our end users. And today we did a special cake for this event. It looks like this. It's huge.
I cannot get over this cake. Oh my goodness!
Like
it's really out of this world.
Yeah,
yes.
I have not tried it yet. It should be sweet. Like, I will tweet later how, you know, nice it is, but at least it looks very good.
So. Amazing. Thank you so much. Yeah. And now going back to technology, do you want to tell us a little bit about Jelastic and how do you guys support Jakarta EE?
Yeah, definitely. So what is in the world Jelastic? It started from Java Elastic. So we were dreaming to make Java elastic and scalable, and we did it. So we did it with OpenJDK. It became more elastic and scalable, less memory greedy on memory consumption, let's say. And also we do support Jakarta EE technologies and microprofiles, so providing easy and smooth way to scale your applications in two directions, vertically and horizontally. So we unlock powerful tools for developers, and they can be more productive with Jelastic now and enjoy the necessary heavy ability and elasticity and scaling, so they can enjoy cloud native characteristic features with our platform in a simple and easy way. And the best thing what I like about Jelastic is a community as well. So behind Jelastic, we have a community of service providers around the world. So it's not only our company. We're just doing simple part. We're doing small part of this job. We are doing software, but there are many partners around the world who are managing data centers and infrastructure. And just a couple of days ago, I was informed that we have more than 100 data centers around the world. And it's a big number for us. So, and after we added support of Jakarta EE, it became immediately available across all the data centers around the world. So this is in short about Jelastic, about what we do. And at this session, at my session, I would like to focus specifically on scaling, you know, because everyone likes scaling. People want to know how to do it. I will show some tricks that can help you to become more efficient. and I will show you how it works specifically within Jelastic.
Thank you.
Good. Should I go ahead?
Yes, please. Feel free.
Sounds good. So as I mentioned, today we will talk about scaling Jakarta EE applications vertically and horizontally within Jelastic Platform as a Service. A little bit about myself. As I mentioned, I am co-founder and CEO of Jelastic. Our company won Duke Choice Award 2 times. We built nice product and community recognized our contribution. And I became Java champion about a year and a half ago, something like this. Yeah, and I'm very respectful for this award. Today, we will talk about vertical and horizontal scaling, about general meaning for the beginning. So we will try to understand like what is the difference when one is better than another one and how to use them. And of course, we will talk how to apply this scalability for Jakarta EE applications and what kind of problems we can we may face and how to overcome them, specifically when we are scaling vertically, because horizontal scaling actually is more well-studied area comparing to vertical scaling for Java. And some testing as well. So let's start vertical and horizontal scaling, what it is. Vertical scaling, it means when you add more resources to the same instance. It can be virtual machine, it can be container, or even bare metal. So it means you increase capacity of your current server. Horizontal scaling means when you create more servers, more containers, more virtual machines, or more bare metal servers. So each of these methods has pros and cons. For example, vertical scaling, it can be easier to deploy and configure because in the most cases, you don't need to do anything extra except some additional config adjustments just to let your application know that there are more resources available now. And for applications, in the most cases, it requires zero code change. So you just use the same application and don't need to redesign architecture. You don't need to do anything for vertical scaling. And there is no need in data synchronization, which simplifies significantly management of the applications. And there is no network and latency issues. So for example, if you host multiple stacks, very often in the past specifically, people like to host application server and database in the same instance, right? So if you in the same server, if you scale vertically the same server, there is no latency and connection issues. Again, like it simplifies the whole architecture. Efficiency, you can get more efficient, you can scale your applications in more efficient way using vertical scaling. And very good point about vertical scaling is that today cloud vendors offer large range of high memory instances, let's say. So you can go and buy like even like 256 gigabyte of RAM, like instances like this, right? You can start from like from 1 gigabyte and end up like 100 gigabyte. So scaling range today is much higher and larger comparing to the past. So, and please remember, if you want to boost your performance, vertical scaling is the fastest way to do this. Of course, it has some limits, but in the most cases, if it just performance is just an issue for you, adding more resources can solve your problem. What are the concerns? Of course, there is no high availability, and you cannot use only vertical scaling for production workloads, for mission critical workloads. Because if infrastructure fails, and infrastructure always fails, just keep it in mind, I can tell you, having experience working with 100 data centers. So vertical scaling is not enough for production applications. And it's also, if you use physical boxes, it's very hard to add more resources to the same box without downtime of your application. So you have to migrate to another physical box, to a bigger one if you want to scale vertically, and you need to implement live migration, which is another kind of technology, and it can be challenging. Now about horizontal scaling. Of course, horizontal scaling is the only way to go for fault tolerance and high variability. At least two nodes are required to achieve high variability mode. Of course, better resiliency and of data and services. Rolling deploys without downtimes can be achieved with horizontal scaling as well. So you deploy to new instance while move traffic to existing ones while redeploy application in one of the instances, and then move traffic back when it's ready. Horizontal scaling can provide better performance for highly loaded projects. If, for example, vertical scaling is not enough for you anymore, so then horizontal scaling again can speed up performance for some projects. There are so many tools already for configuring high variability and horizontal scaling today. So this job can be done easily compared to the past, and which is super great now. So life of developers becomes easier. And it, again, like as mentioned, it's must have for business and mission critical applications. What are the concerns? Designing applications for horizontal scaling can be a challenge. Of course, it can be easy to do with stateless applications because you don't need to worry about anything, right? But still, like if you want to scale applications with state inside, like databases, right? You still want to sometimes to scale databases, or you want to scale Java applications that have state inside. It can be a challenge for you. So you need to know how to synchronize this state across multiple instances. Also, with horizontal scaling, if you don't pay attention on vertical scaling, you might go you might spend much more money because you may over allocate resources, unnecessary resources, and you will have to pay for them. And going horizontal scaling, you have to buy additional licenses if you use commercial software, of course. And in the most cases, it increases load and management complexity on network level and at the end on your team. So keep it in mind. And in my opinion, the best combination is when you use both of them inside the application. So let's talk and let's compare how scaling works inside virtual machines and containers. I like to compare virtual machines and containers very much. In Jelastic, we use containers mostly today. We are planning to add virtual machines, but for only specific workloads. But for majority of our customers, like for all of our customers actually today, containers is a good solution. And why we like containers? Because when you go with virtual machines, there are two things that I personally don't like very much. First of all, overhead for operating system, you can see like this great gray area, is much higher comparing to containers. So if you scale horizontally, right, if you have like, let's say 10 virtual machines or 100 virtual machines, you waste some amount of resources just for operating system. And also, and majority of cloud vendors today offer you virtual machine, and you have to pay regardless of real consumption. And it means there is some amount of resources that are not used, which is not used, but you still pay for it. And in the most cases, people try to get a little bit more than they need, just in case if load comes. It's possible to do a resize of virtual machine on the fly, but it's a very hard difficult technology, which is called ballooning. And actually, cloud vendors just don't offer this option. Majority of cloud vendors do not offer this option of resizing virtual machines on the fly. With containers, it's different. Again, like they are much slimmer in terms of overhead. There is less overhead inside containers. And resources that are not used, even you set a limit, but resources that are not used, they automatically shared with other containers on the host. The key word here is automatically. You don't need to do anything. It's shared by default. And it's very good because it can increase density it can reduce cost of your infrastructure at the end. And if we compare scaling of virtual machine and containers, so here you can see, for example, we started with a small virtual machine, like 4 GB of RAM, right? And at some point, our application grew up to the limit, and it requires now like 5 GB of RAM. Unfortunately, today, at the most public cloud vendors, I cannot just add 1 more GB to the same virtual machine. I cannot scale it easily. So what I have to do, I have to buy 2 times bigger virtual machine. So if I had like 4 GB, I will have to buy 8 GB. And now I have to do manual migration. So extract my data from the previous one and put into new one. And repeat the same if I need to grow beyond my current limit. With containers, we do differently. So you can scale them up and down, and we add and remove resources from the same instance. You don't have to do manual migration or like any kind of migration from the same virtual machine. It's simple and easy with containers. And it works with Java as well. So how it looks inside Jelastic, there is a very simple drag and drop button. By the way, you can see like there is a Payara, right? We support Payara and Glassfish and others. I will show a little bit later the whole list of Jakarta EE stacks we support. But just to let you know how to scale Jakarta EE applications within Jelastic vertically, you just go inside dashboard and there is a panel and 2 sliders. So you drag the slider, which is called like scaling limit, and you set just scaling limit, and that's it. So for example, in my demo, I have Glassfish cluster, right? And I have 3 workers and 1 dust node. And at the moment, the workers have like 2 GB of RAM. But for example, if I did the wrong estimation in the beginning, I need 4 GB of RAM for my workers. I don't need to reprovision the whole cluster. So what I do, I just adjust these workers like this and apply. And in a minute, the system will reconfigure this for me, and I will have my updated workers with the same data inside. So easy, right? But it's not enough, again, just to increase containers limits. You need to do something extra, and specifically for Java applications. You need to adjust XMX parameter, because if you just add more resources and you don't adjust this XMX parameter, which is heap size, your Java application, as any Java application, including Jakarta EE application servers, will not be able to utilize these resources available now in the container. So in Jelastic, when you do a change of scaling limit, we automatically adjust this limit for you. By default, we have 80%, which is allocated to XMX to heap size. You can adjust this ratio just changing parameter of environment variable inside the container. And Jelastic will automatically adjust this for you afterward. Good. So again, just to pay attention when you run inside virtual machines, what might happen. At this illustration, you can see, this combination is the best when you have like virtual machine inside Java virtual machine red, right? And you allocated resources properly, like so on all levels. Actually, you need to think not only about XMX, there are other areas that can consume RAM, like direct max memory, metaspace, and number of threads multiplied on XFF. I will not go so deep, but just to let you know that you need to reserve some memory, not only for heap, but and for extra objects, for metaspace in Java. So this is the ideal combination. But what happens if you set it improperly? So there are 2 cases. over allocation, so you put much more resources, right? And with virtual machines, it's a problem because like you will pay for this unused resources and your application will never consume this. So you need to precisely adjust the limits. And under allocation, when you configure GVM incorrectly, and at some point, GVM may go beyond of current virtual machine or container limits, and then this virtual GVM will be killed by operating system. So it's the worst case because you will lose data, your instance will go down. So keep it in mind. And as I mentioned, with Jelastic, we solve significant problem, which is called right sizing problem. You don't need to guess in advance how much resources you need to configure for your application, for your Java application, how much resources you need to buy from a cloud vendor in advance. Because, as I mentioned, you can see now we have our configs applied and we go and can check what is the current usage. So the scaling limit here is 12 gigabyte. Current usage now is 1.5 gigabyte. If we go with old school pay-as-you-go model, you will have to pay for 12 gigabyte. With pay-as-you-use or pay-per-use model, you pay only for 1.5 gigabyte. It's very cost efficient. You can see the difference here more than 10 times, right? So this is very unique and revolutionary model. It's based on vertical scaling. And it again, like it solves the right sizing problem. No need to think in advance how much resources to allocate. And the good point is we did the testing and checked across many years how our end users use this vertical scaling. And you can see vertical scaling is much higher than real used resources. So if our system charge for the limits, we will charge much more end customers at the end, which actually do other cloud vendors do. But we don't want it. We want more fair pricing. This is why we invented pay-per-use. Now coming back to horizontal scaling. As I mentioned, when we scale containers, scaling can be done in two ways, stateless and stateful. Stateless scaling, it means when you create a new worker node with no state inside. So you create it from a container template. It same can be applied for Jakarta EE, of course. Stateful, it means when you clone your master node. So you clone some data already, and you create a new instance from the master. Stateless approach scaling is much easier and faster because you don't need to worry about the data. Stateful is more complicated one and slower one because like you need to copy data, and if you want to achieve anti-affinity, you have to migrate this container to another physical box. Within Jelastic, two options are available. So it's easier to go when you create an environment here, right? For example, Tomcat, right? I want to like phone nodes, and I can choose, I want a stateless or stateful scaling. So next time when you add, because at the beginning, like all of them will be like empty, right? But next time when you add more nodes, for example, if you choose stateful, the master node will be cloned and migrated to dedicated, let's say, physical node to achieve anti-affinity. So just keeping in mind again, like, so there are two options for scaling. Also, there is an option to do automatic horizontal scaling. When you go to configs panel, right, and there is auto horizontal scaling, you can add triggers based on CPU, memory, network, and disk. And it's quite easy. So you say like, please, you choose layer. You want to scale workers, for example, right? You choose layer and say, okay, please scale out to 10 nodes by one node if load is more than 70%. And please remove scale in to 3 nodes if load is less than, let's say, like 20%, right? And you add this trigger. easy. That's it. So you don't need to implement very complex, you know, tracking of memory usage or like CPU usage and applying triggers. Like, it's done already for you. In a couple clicks, you can get fully functional automatic horizontal scaling. Then I mentioned anti-affinity roles. What it means? When you create nodes, multiple nodes of the same layer, it means like load balancing layer, application server layer, database layer, or any other layer. We have them here. Like load balancer, application server, let's say we have like DAS layer, domain administration server. So all containers from the same layer, we distribute across available physical nodes. So by default, we do not put containers of this from the same layer on the same physical node. We do it for a reason, because if physical node fails, your other containers will stay alive. It means your habitability will work, because if you put everything on one physical node and nodes fails, and like, you know, there are no data centers that don't have servers that fail. So anti-affinity rules helps you to achieve this habitability. And you don't even think about it when you create Jakarta EE application within Jelastic, because it's done automatically for you. And we believe you don't need to worry about this. It's more for system administrators. Good. And of course, for more advanced guys, within Jelastic, it's possible to configure custom actions. You can subscribe custom actions on specific events. Jelastic is fully like event-based solution. There is on before scale out, on after scale out, before scale in, after scale in, add node, remove node. So there are multiple events you can subscribe. And it means you can execute specific actions before scaling or after scaling. It's necessary for specifically useful for traditional or so-called like legacy applications when you want to go and to do some extra configurations on a specific node. For example, if your application was not designed for cloud native approach, when all discovery happens automatically, you can improve your application behavior using these events. But now, specifically for Jakarta, we support a wide range of application servers, including Jakarta EE, such as Glassfish, Payara, Tomcat, TomEE, Wildfly. We plan to add OpenLiberty as well in the future. But for now, we support this stack. And for this application servers, we provide super cool feature, which is called automatic clusterization. So there is only one button. You just press this button, and the system will automatically create a cluster topology for you. Cluster topology depends on a specific application server. So for Tomcat, it's one kind of topology. For Wildfly, it's another kind of topology. So we analyzed and studied what are these cluster topologies in each application server, and we implemented automation for this. So, and now it looks like this. As you can see, I have already a cluster here, right? With one load balancer, three application server worker nodes, and one DAS, which is called domain administration server. So, and I have my Glassfish admin panel, and you can see I have like three nodes here, right? I need to log in because my session expired. I have this login here. Yeah. So I can go here and see, okay, I have like three nodes. Yeah, they're connected automatically. Now, what happens if I scale my cluster and add one more node? So let's add actually two more nodes, right? I press button apply. The system will create two containers on two different physical nodes and will automatically connect these containers to this DAS node. And we will see these two more nodes here a little bit later. But to show you again, like from the beginning, how I got this cluster. So you go like to, you press button, create new environment, and then you can see the list of different application servers, including Jakarta EE, right? Glassfish, Tomcat 10, new one, Payara, actually new version is coming soon, Tommy as well, Whitefly, JT is here. And yeah, let's go with Glassfish. I like Glassfish, actually. So, and then you can choose different OpenJDK builds. Let's go with adopt OpenJDK. And then I say like, I want auto clustering. So you just press this button and we automatically, you know, configure this cluster for you. We automatically add one more cluster, Glassfish node, which is called DAS. And then when you add more nodes, we automatically create load balancer. For now we use Nginx, but you can change to any other one, right, that we support. And then you say like, okay, please create, like give like 6 GB per each worker node. And please give, let's say like 4 GB per DAS node. And that's it, pretty simple. And then you choose location where you want to deploy. This is a demo cluster. This is our demo cluster. So usually when you go to a Jelastic provider, they have different data centers. But in our demo, I use premium. I like this region. And my demo Glassfish cluster, let's say, right? So I print environment name and press button create. And in a couple of minutes, I will get my cluster. And while it's creating, let's check the previous environment. So you see now I added two more nodes. They are here. Let's check if they're available now in my Glassfish. So yeah, now we have like five nodes inside the cluster. Inside the Glassfish, and I don't need to do any manual work now. Just a couple buttons, or I can call APIs. And it's done. So the system will do everything for me. Pretty exciting. And because like, look, there is a lot of work behind this. And now it's just invisible for developers. I was dreaming about such kind of tools when I was developing, like, let's say like 5 years ago. Good. And of course you can deploy directly to Glassfish. So from as archive or as connecting to Git or SVN repo, let's deploy our Hello World application. So I can choose our workers, like five workers, right? So, and yeah. And I can define some specific hooks and press button, deploy. And in a minute, our application will be deployed to Glassfish. So yeah. For now, it should be standard web page, but after deployment is done, we will see like Hello World application. Yeah. Good. It should be done already. Let's check. Yeah. You can see my application is deployed now to my Glassfish cluster, to all nodes. And it was super easy, super simple. So we do support also other stacks, as I mentioned, like Tomcat, Tommy, Whitefly, JT, Payara, and Open Liberty are coming soon to our platform as well. Like, I mean, new versions of Payara will come soon, and Open Liberty support. We are working with Open Liberty folks to figure out what is the best way to do it within Jelastic. Good. And a little bit about vertical scaling and about memory consumption, because that's one of the biggest problem in Java community in general. And it's not only for Jakarta EE projects, like, so, but survey of Jakarta EE shows that memory, large memory requirements is the biggest issue across Jakarta EE projects. Like 40% of respondents highlighted this issue. And why it's like this? There are several areas, actually, a couple areas that can be improved. First of all, like how much memory are required for applications to be run and consumed by GVM. And second is, what is the efficiency of GVM? How much RAM in reality it consumes? Yeah, because if you go inside and analyze the usage, you might be surprised very much. Because I saw in many cases the following, like blue line, it means how many memory is consumed by objects. So it's a real usage. And orange, it means how much RAM is reserved by GVM. So how much RAM GVM said, like, okay, give me it from, and it takes from operating system and it reserves this RAM. And as you can see, at some cases, it can be like we have almost no objects. So blue line is close to zero, but the orange line stay high, which is crazy. So it means like GVM consumes RAM, but in reality, it doesn't need it. And we figure out this problem and was fighting this problem. And we solved this problem by introducing a new parameters for OpenJDK inside OpenJDK, which is they available from Java 12. And they will influence even Jakarta EE applications. So you can tune periodic garbage collections cycles. So when there is no need for memory anymore, GVM will be able to release this memory back to operating system. And at the end, you will get something like this, which is very cool, because if your GVM doesn't consume RAM and you are running inside containers, all these unused resources can be shared with other containers and with other applications on the same physical host. You can increase density significantly, like 3-5 times on the same infrastructure. As I showed you in the past, right? So people consume much less than they set the limits. So if your RAM keeps these limits, you will waste all these resources. But now there is a possibility to return these resources. And community recognized this contribution when we won Duke Chase Awards in 2018. But again, like as I mentioned, it's available for Java 12. If you want to enjoy for Java 11 and lower versions, you can apply Java Agent. You can go to this GitHub repo and just attach the Java Agent in the following way. And this agent will periodically check if there is a possibility to reduce memory consumption and will bring it down. So, and you will get something like this again. Like it's still not ideal, but at least you can get memory release when you don't need it anymore. Please pay attention to performance. So you don't need to do it for like highly performant applications. If performance is number one for you, don't release memory never, like because you want to get performance at maximum performance at any time. But if you use like development environments, like testing environments, or like your let's say production environment has variable load, right? So sorry, for example, during the night it has less load, so it may help you to save a lot of resources. And we did a simple test at the end. I'm finishing. Simple test with GlassFish. So we deployed a simple application, and yeah, you can find this application on this GitHub, and enabled three different garbage collectors, tested for vertical scaling. Parallels, it just consumes RAM, it doesn't release back. New garbage, G1 in Java 12 and later versions, it can be scaled down. And same with Shenandoah. Shenandoah is another good new garbage collector, which is scalable vertically. So finalizing, vertical scaling can solve right sizing problem. You don't need to guess in advance how much resources you need to buy. So CPU and RAM can be available to your application at a specific point of time immediately with containers. Actual consumption automatically monitored and charged according to real consumption. And if you want to adjust the scaling limit, you don't need to do any manual migration. So you can add more resources to the same infrastructure. I'm talking specifically about vertical scaling in Jelastic. Horizontal scaling within Jelastic solves scalability problem. So we provide auto-clustering for Jakarta EE applications. It's easier to do clusters now. And you can add automatic triggers for automatic horizontal scaling. And you can choose stateful or stateless scaling mode. And of course, we have anti-affinity for extra security. And at the end, you can use our sexy and nice UI or like API or Jelastic packaging standard. So if you like my presentation, please follow me at Twitter, or if you have problems with Jakarta EE scaling applications, please let me know. We have a specific email like safememory@jelastic.com, and our team can jump and help you to fight your problems. I hope you like it. Yes.
We love your presentation, and I have a couple of questions here. And you can see one is from Drajan, the other one is from Marco. So let me start with Drajan. So do you have deployment scripts for creating and deploying environments, continuous deployment, push button deployments, and so on?
We do. So we have Git push deploy. Actually, let me share my screen. Oops. So we have a couple options. By default, for example, we have this nice one. You can add, for example, your Git repo here, right? You put a repo, you put credentials, and then you will get this repo registered at this panel. Then you do the following. You press the button, and you choose environment where you want to deploy, for example, Glassfish, right? And then you can specify like the working directory, hooks, pre-deployment hooks, pre-build hooks, post-build hooks, pre-deploy hooks, post-deploy hooks. And then you can also specify check out to deploy updates. So like system will automatically check updates every minute. And if there is an update, it will automatically again like pull, do your hooks if you define them, and deploy to your other two application. There is another add-on, Git push the deploy add-on. Again, like you just specify repo, user token, and an environment, and that's it. Like if it's Java environment, for example, then the system will automatically create Maven also, and apply builds. So this is how it works inside Jelastic.
Okay, so there is another question. Is this like a lens tool for Java applications? And can we use a Kubernetes cluster with the Jelastic?
Yes, so we love Kubernetes. Actually, even there is some redundancy between Jelastic and Kubernetes because Jelastic was designed to scale applications. But we, again, like we love Kubernetes. There is a Kubernetes inside Jelastic marketplace. Yeah, and you can choose clean deploy cluster or deploy custom Helm stack or operator even. And by default, by the way, by default, we deploy Open Liberty operator. So when you deploy Kubernetes, you will see like Open Liberty deployed inside. And you can choose development or production mode. Development is just one master and one worker by default. You can scale workers later. Production is like three masters and two API balancers and two workers. You can scale them later as well. You can choose different ingress controllers. You can choose two options for Kubernetes dashboard. You can attach NFS storage with dynamic volume provisioning. You can install Prometheus, Grafana, Jaeger, and enable remote APIs. And of course, you can choose region. Yeah. So it's possible to do Kubernetes with Jelastic and deploy your Java inside. Yeah.
Ruslan, we'll definitely have to have more conversations because this is a super interesting topic and people are definitely interested. So we will arrange, if nothing sooner, we can arrange always another conversation with Ruslan at the Jakarta Tech Talks. But Ruslan, thank you. Ruslan, thank you so much.
Thank you.
I love that cake.
Oh, let's celebrate together.
Okay, see you all in the next session. Thank you so much.
Thank you, guys. Yeah, bye. Bye-bye.